NFT is one mathematical process which is useful for the conversion of a signal from time domain to frequency domain. Let us define it. It is a finite duration discrete frequency sequence which is obtained by sampling one period of Fourier transform, and sampling is done at n equal spaced points. So mathematically, the DFT, that is the discrete Fourier transform of a sequence x of n, it is defined by x of k is equal to summation running from n is equal to 0 up to n minus 1 x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi n k divided by n, where the value of k, it is running from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n minus 1. Since the summation is taken at n discrete points, hence it is called as n-point discrete Fourier transform or the DFT. We are having the two different methods for the computation of DFT of a given sequence. First one is the matrix method, and another one is by using the standard formula of the DFT. So let us see the matrix method. Here, to determine the DFT of a sequence, first step we have to follow, that we have to determine the length of sequence, that is the capital N. In second step, we have to determine the transformation matrix Wn. Here the Tweedle factor, which is given by Wn into k raised to n, is equal to e raised to minus j 2 pi kn divided by capital N. And we have to perform the multiplication of this transformation matrix and the input sequence matrix, which will give us directly the DFT of this sequence. And finally, we have to summarize all the DFTs of this sequence. So let us take one example. Here the given sequence is x of n having the samples 0, 1, 2, 3. And we have to determine its endpoint DFT by using matrix method. So we have to follow the first step. We have to determine the length of this sequence. As here we are having total 4 number of samples, so n will be equal to 4. Secondly, we have to determine the transformation matrix, that is the Wn, that is the W of 4. So as here n is equal to 4, the transformation matrix will be of 4 by 4 size, a square matrix. So the elements of this transformation matrix, that are nothing but the Tweedle factors. And the Tweedle factor, that is the e raised to minus j 2 pi nk. So if we solve it mathematically, this transformation matrix we are getting for the 4 by 4 matrix. The next step we have to follow, that we have to multiply the transformation matrix with the input sequence matrix. So here this is the transformation matrix and this is the input sequence matrix. When we do the multiplication of these two matrices, here we are getting the DFT of this sequence. Let us see the another one method for the calculation of a DFT by using the standard formula. The steps that we have to follow for the determination of a DFT by using the standard formula is as follows. First of all, we have to determine the sequence length, that is the capital N. Secondly, we have to use the standard DFT formula, that is the x of k is summation running from n is equal to 0, n minus 1, x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi nk divided by n, where the value of k will range from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n minus 1. In step 3, we have to apply the different values of k, and we have to determine the individual DFTs, that is the x of k. And finally, we have to summarize all the DFTs. Let us take one simple example. Here the given input sequence x of n is having the 4 samples 1, 0, 0, 1, and we have to determine its DFT by using the standard formula. So as usual, the first step will be to determine the length of sequence. As here we are having the 4 samples in this x of n, so the n, capital N, will be equal to 4. In second step, we have to apply the standard DFT formula, that is the x of k is equal to summation running from n is equal to 0, n minus 1, x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi nk divided by n, Here the k's value will run from 0 up to n minus 1. So here let us apply the value of capital N, that is equal to 4. So here the equation will be reduced to x of k summation running from n is equal to 0 up to 3 into x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi n k divided by capital N, that is equal to 4. And here the value of k will be ranged from 0, 1 to 3. In next step, we have to apply the value of k, that is equal to 0. That is the k's value that are starting from 0 and up to n minus 1. So for this particular, this example, the k's value is running from 0 up to 3. So let us apply these different values of k and let's find out the DFT of the given sequence. So when we apply k is equal to 0, so equation will reduce like this way, that is the summation n running from 0 up to 3 x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi n k. Now here the k's value is equal to 0 divided by 4. So this Tweedle factor term will be equal to e raised to 0, that is nothing but 1. So now we have to apply the different values of x of n, and after having this value, we are getting the DFT for the x of 1 like this way. In next step, let's apply the value of k is equal to 1 in the standard DFT formula. So x of 1 will be equal to n running from 0 up to 3 x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi n k divided by 4. Now the k's value will be equal to 1. So after simplification of this equation, we are getting the x of 1 like this way, and we are applying the different values of n. So that will be equal to x of 0 e raised to 0 plus x of 1 e raised to minus j pi by 2 plus x of 2 e raised to minus j pi plus x of 3 e raised to minus j 3 pi by 2. Now here, after solving this equation, we are applying the different x of 0, x of 1, x of 2 that are nothing but the different sequences over here. So after applying these values, we are getting the DFT x of 1 in this fashion. Let us follow the same steps by applying k is equal to 2, and here equation of this DFT, that is the standard equation of DFT, will reduce like this way. After simplifying this equation and applying the value of n and applying the values of the x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, x of 3, we are getting the DFT that is equal to 0 over here. In step 5, we have to apply the last value of k, that is k is equal to 3. Same procedure we have to follow. X of 3 will be equal to summation running from n is equal to 0 up to n minus 1 x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi n 3 divided by 4. And here after simplifying this, the x of 2 will be reduced in this fashion. And we have to apply the different values of n which are running from n is equal to 0 up to 3. And we are applying the sequence x of 0, x of 1, x of 2 and x of 3. So finally, we are getting this DFT over here. So let us summarize this. After summarizing this, we will get all the DFTs of the given sequence. That is the technique for determination of a DFT of a given sequence by using the standard formula.